In this video, we will lay down the basic matrix calculus background we need for backpropagation. You know, backpropagation is all about taking partial derivatives of functions with respect to inputs and weights. So we need to understand the different ways in which functions can be represented, how to take the partial derivative of those functions in each of those different scenarios. So without further ado, let's jump straight into it. All right, so let's assume we have a function f of x. So what are all the different forms in which the function f of x could happen? For example, f of x could be a scalar valued function. For example, it could be something like this, 3x squared plus 2x. So this is a scalar valued function because if you substitute the values of x into this function, you will end up with a scalar value. For example, if x is equal to 1, this will evaluate, the function will evaluate to 5, which is a scalar value, so this is a scalar valued function. A scalar valued function is a function that retains a scalar no matter how much the values of x changes. Okay. But also f of x could be a vector valued function. What is a vector valued function? A vector valued function is a function that returns a vector. So for example, f of x could be 3x squared and 2x, right? Substituting x here and here, let's say x is equal to 1, so we end up with 3 and 2, vector 3, 2. So the function f of x is a function that returns a vector for each value of x. Likewise, f of x could also be a matrix valued function. A matrix valued function f of x is a function that returns a matrix for each value of x, 3x squared, 2x, 2x, 4x. So for each value of x, we will return a different matrix. So because the function returns a matrix, it's a matrix valued function, and in this case it's a matrix valued function of a single variable. And actually, in all of these cases we discussed scalar valued functions of a single variable, vector valued functions of a single variable, and matrix valued functions of a single variable. By single variable I mean x is just one single variable. F is a function of one single variable, but f could also be a function of multiple variables, x1, x2, all the way up to xn. Actually, the variable x itself could come in the form of a vector, x1, x2, x3, and so on. Or x could be a matrix, x11, x12, x21, x22. So when we think about taking partial derivatives of the function f with respect to x, we need to understand if our function is a scalar valued function, a vector valued function, or a matrix valued function, and is it a function of a single variable or a function of multivariables. So what is an example of a matrix valued function of multiple variables? For example, something like this, f of x equal to 3x1, 2x2, 4x3, and 5x1. So this is a matrix valued function because it retains a matrix when we substitute in the values of x, and it's a matrix valued function of multiple variables. In this case, x here is this vector x1, x2, x3. All right, so this is a quick introduction into the different types of functions. Now let's go into viewing them one by one and seeing how do we take the derivative of the function with respect to x in each and every scenario. So let's say f of x is a scalar valued function and x is a single variable. So this is the easiest situation. Here, f of x will be equal to 3x squared, 2x plus len x. Taking partial f by partial x here will be simple. So f prime of x is equal to 6x plus 2 plus 1 over x. Great. So that is that. First example. Now let's take the second example. F is a scalar valued function and x is multivariate. Let's say x is x1 and x2. This is vector x. So let's say f of x here is equal to 3x1 squared plus 2x2 plus len x3. Taking partial derivative of x is equal to, in this case, we're taking partial derivative of a function with respect to a vector of variables. The result will be a vector. When you take partial f by partial x1, that's 6x1, partial f by partial x2, that's 2, partial f by partial x3, that's 1 over x3. Amazing. Okay, now let's see if f is a scalar valued function and x is a matrix, x11, x12, x21, x22. So an example of a scalar valued function is, and again, 6x11 plus 2x21 squared plus ln x12. So why is this a scalar valued function? Because substituting the values of x11, 2, 1, and 1, 2 here, we will end up with a scalar value, like 0.1, 0.01, or 10, or whatever. All of these are scalars. So this is a scalar valued function of elements of a matrix. So it's a scalar multivariate function where the variables are the elements of this matrix. So how will we go about taking the partial derivative of f with respect to matrix x? So f prime of x in this situation is, we need to take the derivative of f with respect to each element in the matrix. So it will be partial f by partial x11, partial f by partial x12, partial f by partial x21, partial f by partial x22. And the reason we do this is that every change in each element of x will result in a change in f of x itself. So if we need to check the gradient of f with respect to x, we need to check the gradient of f with respect to each element of x, because for a slight change in each one of those elements, a slight change would change the entire value of f, and we need to measure that change, and that is exactly what the gradient is measuring. Okay, so what is the gradient of f with respect to x11 is 6, with respect to x21, that's 4 x21. Oh, sorry, this is x12. So with respect to x12 is 1 over x12, partial f by partial x21, that will be 4 x21. And then partial f by partial x22, there isn't an element, so it would be 0. So that was the third scenario. Okay, scenario number 4. So now we finished looking at all the different scenarios when f was a scalar valued function. Now let's look at f when f is a vector valued function and x is a single variable. An example, f of x is equal to 3x squared 2x, taking the derivative of this, simple and easy, it will be partial f by partial x, that will be 3, partial f by partial x again, that will be 2, so this is the f prime of x. Okay. Next scenario, again f of x, f is a vector, and x is a vector, so x here is x1, x2, and f is function of x, vector x, right? So it will be 3x1 square 2x2. Taking the derivative here, we will call this f1, call this f2. So taking the derivative, so what will be the derivative of f of x, which is a vector valued function with respect to vector x? I personally think about it this way. So I call this, if this is a vector valued function, each element of this vector valued function is a scalar valued function, right? So 3x1 square is a scalar valued function of x1. So taking partial f by partial, so partial f by partial x is equal to partial f1 by partial x1, partial f1 by partial x2, partial f2 by partial x1, partial f2 by partial x2. Okay? Because the derivative of a scalar valued function with respect to a vector is a vector in itself, which is this vector. And again here, derivative of scalar valued function with respect to a vector is a vector, which is this one. So it's a matrix of vectors, which is basically, it's a vector of vectors, which is basically a matrix. So partial f1 by partial x1 is, let's compute it quickly, 6 x1, 0, 0, partial f2 by partial, with respect to x2 is 2, partial f2 with respect to x1 is 0, because there isn't any x1 here, so that is the gradient. Okay, now let's take a more complicated example. Let's look at gradient of f with respect to x, when f is a vector and x is a matrix. So in this situation, it's x11, x12, x21, x22. So let's give an example. F of x is equal to 3x1, 2, sorry, 3x11, 2x12, and x21. Okay, so again, I'll call this f1, f2, f3. And what is the derivative of f1, which is a scalar, again, a scalar valued function? F, so f is a vector valued function, but f1 is a scalar valued function. So what's the derivative of a scalar valued function with respect to a matrix? We've seen this in the third example we gave. The derivative of a scalar with respect to a matrix, a scalar function with respect to a matrix, is a matrix. So the resulting output will be a vector of matrices, right? Matrix 1, matrix 2, matrix 3. Basically, this matrix is partial f1 by partial x, partial f2 by partial x, partial f3 by partial x. When we expand it, partial f1 by partial x11, partial f1 by partial x12, partial f1 by partial x21, partial f1 by partial x22. And same for x2, for f2, partial f2 by partial x11, partial f2 by partial x12, partial f2 by partial x21, partial f2 by partial x22. So this is a vector of matrices, which is basically a tensor. Okay, so this is a three-dimensional vector. Can we make it more complicated? Let's take first a simple example. Let's take f of, let's take f as a matrix and x as a scalar. Again, an example could be 3x, 2x, x, 4x squared. Let's take the derivative of this, 3, 2, 1, 8x. Okay, so the last example for today. Now, f is a matrix valued function and x is a vector. Matrix valued function and x is a vector. So let's give an example. Let's say x is x1 and x2. So an f of x is 3x1, 2x2, 4x1, 3x2. I'm going to call this f1, f2, f3, f4. So f of x is a matrix valued function, but each element of f of x is a vector, is a scalar valued function. So f1, f2, f3, f4 are scalar valued functions. So let's take partial f prime of x will be partial f1 by partial x, partial f2 by partial x, partial f3 by partial x, and partial f4 by partial x. And partial f1 by partial x is partial f1 by partial x1 and partial f2 by partial x2. partial f2 by partial x is partial f2 by partial x1 and partial f2 by partial x2, and so on for f3 and x3. You compute those vectors and substitute them here, and you'll end up with, again, a tensor, a matrix of vectors. The next lecture, we're going to give some concrete examples from actual functions in backpropagation, like the loss function. The loss function, for example, something like the cross entropy loss, that is a scalar valued function. And we want to take the partial of the loss function with respect to the weights. The weights are a matrix in a fully connected layer, right? We have all of these weights here. W11, W, we have W11, W12, W21, W22, and the loss function is just a scalar valued function. So taking partial derivative of the loss function with respect to the weights is, again, a matrix, a derivative of a scalar with respect to a matrix, that will be a matrix. So to be partial L by partial W11, partial L by partial W12, and so on until partial loss by partial W22. This is just an example from backpropagation. In the next video, we're gonna take more concrete examples. Until then, if you found this video helpful, don't forget to click the like button, it helps a lot. And if you have any questions on the content in this video, please leave it down in the comments below. Thank you so much, and see you in the next video.